Director of the Swami Vivekananda Cultural Center at the Consulate General of India in Durban, Dr. Chaitanya Prakash Yogi, Revered Swami Sumanasananda Ji, Mr. Piyush Khandalwal, Mr. Sapiwe Mchunu, distinguished guests, online viewers, namaskar and welcome to the Swami Vivekananda Jayanti celebration. Indeed, today we celebrate National Youth Day of India, also known as Vivekananda Jayanti, which is celebrated on the 12th of January, being the birthday of Swami Vivekananda. In 1984, the government of India declared this day as National Youth Day, and since 1985, the event is celebrated in India every year. The National Youth Day is observed all over India at schools and colleges with processions, speeches, music, youth conventions, seminars, yoga asanas, presentations, competitions in essay writing, recitation, and sports on 12th January every year. Swami Vivekananda's lectures and writings deriving their inspiration from the Indian spiritual tradition and the broad outlook of his master, Sri Ramakrishna Paramahansa. These were a source of inspiration and have motivated numerous youth organizations, study circles, and service projects involving the youth. Indeed, to commence today's program, we would like to begin with a Bhajan rendition by Nivalji, Vishalji, and Taranaji, youth members of the Ramakrishna Center, South Africa, Glen Annul. Indeed, this program is in association with the Ramakrishna Center of South Africa, Glen Annul. Just a brief background about the youth members. Nivalji is a youth member of the Ramakrishna Center, South Africa, Durban Center, and is an academic in the field of chemical engineering at the University of KwaZulu-Natal, accompanied by his fellow youth devotees, Vishalji and Taranaji. He has performed an offering, a rendition of a Sanskrit hymn to Swami Vivekananda, composed by Sri Sarath Chandra Chakraborty, a Sanskrit scholar and disciple of Swami Vivekananda Ji.
Bye.
Nivarji, Vishalji, and Taranaji for that really beautiful, soulful, inspiring bhajan rendition. Next, we will be having remarks by Revered Swami Sumanasananda Ji, the spiritual head and president of the Ramakrishna Center of South Africa, Glen Annel. Swami Ji ordained monk of the Ramakrishna Order in 1991 by the most revered Srimad Swami Bhuteshananda Ji Maharaj, the 12th president of the Ramakrishna Mutt and the Ramakrishna Mission. Today, it gives me great honor to welcome revered Swami Sumanasananda Ji for his remarks on Swami Vivekananda's message for youth.
Om Namasri Yatirajaya Vivekananda Suraye Sachit Sukhaswarupaya Swamine Tapaharine. We offer our pranams to that great Swami Vivekananda, whose 160th birthday is being celebrated all over the world, particularly in India and many other countries. Friends, devotees, admirers of Swami Vivekananda, it's really a great privilege for all of us to be part of such a program, which is celebrating not only 160th birthday of Swami Vivekananda, which is marked as the Youth Day, National Youth Day in India. And also this year, it has its special appeal for India because India is celebrating its 75 years of its independence from 1947 to 2022. Azadi ka Amrit Mahotsav. So this is a wonderful occasion that we are being a part and paying our homage to that great Swami who gave up, renounced everything for the good of the humanity, not only for the Indians. And he exercised wonderful influence all over the world, particularly on the youngsters. He used to say himself, yes, my faith is in the younger generation, the modern generation. They will solve all the problems like lions. out of them will come my workers. See the faith and trust Swami Vivekananda had on the youths. And we also find that all over the world, everywhere, young and aged, any people came in touch with Swami Vivekananda could not go back without being influenced. And some words are also so fiery, full of fire, full of inspiration, and full of power also. I just feel tempted to quote that oft-quoted quotation of Mr. Nobel Prize laureate, Mr. Rumarola, French scholar. And he said, and I quote, "I cannot touch these sayings of his, scattered as they are through the pages of books at 30 years' distance, without receiving a thrill through my body like an electric shock. And what shocks, what transports must have been produced when, in burning words, they issued from the lips of the hero." Rumarola, French Nobel laureate, wonderful man who wrote the life of Swami Vivekananda also. And he was such an admirer of Swami Vivekananda that he requested another Nobel laureate, Rabindranath Tagore, that I am going to write a book on India and Swami Vivekananda. Will you please give me some materials? And then Rabindranath Tagore was telling him, if you want to know India, read Vivekananda. In him, everything is positive and nothing negative. And what the youngsters want, there is certain special traits there are in the youths. My topic is Swami Vivekananda's influence on youth. So thanks to the organizers, the Consulate General of India in at Durban for organizing this very befitting program on the occasion of Swami Vivekananda's 160th birthday, 159th birth anniversary, and also 38th Youth Day, in National Youth Day being celebrated in India, which all coincide this year as the Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, 75 years of Indian independence. So I must convey my thanks and gratitude to the Consul General and others associated with this program for having such a nice program, befitting program, to pay our homage to that great Swamiji. Now, coming to the point, Swami Vivekananda had exercised wonderful influence on the youth all over the world. And today we will have the utterances of such people who established themselves in the spiritual field, in the political field, in the social welfare activities. He influenced people, particularly youngsters, belonging to any sphere of life, any walks of life, any walk of life, everywhere people became influenced by Swami Vivekananda. And some quotations, first I read inspiring quotation, then I quote some other people also who got inspired, world famous luminaries who themselves said that what we are, it is the influence of Swami Vivekananda, how they themselves became influenced. And what are the words, wonderful words? Swamiji is telling, all power is within you. Believe in that. Do not believe that you are weak. Stand up and express the divinity within you. All power is within you. You can do anything and everything. Take the whole responsibility on your own shoulder. And what the youngsters feel, as I said, the youngsters have some special traits. Certain traits, they're full of energy, enthusiasm, youthfulness. Youth, Y-O-U-T-H, youth. Y for youthfulness, O for feeling of oneness with the whole universe, with everyone. That they don't have hatred, jealousy with each other, for others. And young people are always very full of inspiration boiling and bubbling with enthusiasm. Youthfulness is there, greenness. And U stands for unselfishness. T for truthfulness. And H for honesty, hardworking, and idealistic. These youth of any country are idealistic. They try to become truthful. They try to remain honest. They try to follow the path of unselfishness. And they feel the oneness, brotherhood with each other, everyone. And they are always very innovative and very enthusiastic. So all these things, traits are found in the lives of the youths anywhere. And Swami Vivekananda exploited these traits being found as not being found, as is found in everywhere amongst the youths. Swami Vivekananda did everything to inspire people everywhere, particularly the youngsters, in all countries, wherever he visited. And we find through her lectures, through his pristine, pure life of renunciation, sagacism, wisdom, spiritual experiences, and his divine oratory. He was an orator by divine right, and he was a born leader by divine right. Anywhere and everywhere, he proved himself to be the leader of the groups, not only in the World's Parliament of Religion, when he attended in 1893. The very first day, he was an unknown man, and he went, nobody knew, no introductory letter, and this is the first time he was facing the public audience, people in general, and 7,000 educated people were his audience, and belonging to 10 major religions, and he started saying sisters and brothers of America, and whatever he said, people were just awestruck that what this young man of 30 years spoke about. So, wherever he went, and the whole light, I will quote from the different books, that how the whole limelight was thrown on Swami Vivekananda from the very first day, because the organizers knew whom to make the last speaker. So Swami Vivekananda spoke 6 times in the World Parliament of Religions. It was, his ideas were so inspiring that he would not be given the chance to speak as the first and second and in the beginning time, first time. Because then after hearing him, all the audience will leave. So give him to the last point so that people remain sitting there to hear Swami Vivekananda. So wonderful response was there all over the world. And Swamiji's words, as I am telling, Swamiji is telling, do not say we are weak. We can do anything and everything. What can we not do? Everything can be done by us. We all have the same glorious soul. Let us believe in it. Generally, youth, sometimes they suffer from frustration, depression, failure, unemployment. And what they need? They need the message of hope, message of self-faith, tremendous mental power. Those are there in the words of Swami Vivekananda. He instilled that hope, that vigorousness, that self-esteem, self-faith in each and every minds of the youngsters through his wonderful life and voice and message and teachings. So Swamiji is telling, let every man and woman and child without respect of caste or birth hear and learn that behind every one, there is that infinite soul, assuring the infinite possibility and the infinite capacity of all to become great and good. Never say no, never say I cannot, for you are infinite. You can do anything and everything. You are almighty. See the words of Swami Vivekananda speaking to the whole world, the humanity. That you are Atman, your soul, never say I cannot do. We are the children of the Almighty. We are sparks of the infinite divine fire. How can we be nothing? We are everything, ready to do everything. We can do everything, and man must do everything. What queer humility is this to say, I know nothing, I am nothing? This is pseudo renunciation and mock modesty. I tell you, off with such a self-debasing spirit. He never entertained any kind of this namby-pambiness. I am worthless. I mean, you are not worthless. You are full of worth. You are the most worthy person on this world. As Jesus Christ has said, that you are the salt on the earth. This human being, Swami Vivekananda also said, you are the children of immortal bliss. How can I address you? Other than that, I must address you as the children of immortal bliss. So those were the wonderful, inspiring words, bringing hope and strength and valor in the minds of the fearlessness, in the minds of not only of the youngsters, anyone used to be in the company of Swami Vivekananda. Cherish positive thoughts, and I quote Swamiji, cherish positive thoughts by dwelling too much upon negativism. The whole country is going to ruin. What a botheration. In every soul is infinite strength. And should you turn yourselves into cats and dogs by harboring negative thoughts, who dares to preach negativism? That sort of self-deprecating attitude is another name of disease. Do you call that humility? It is vanity in disguise. Hurl yourselves on the world like an avalanche. Let the world crack in twain under your weight. So this Swami Vivekananda's wonderful clarion call. Be of good cheer and believe that we are selected by the Lord to do great things, and we will do them. Jesus Christ said, many are called, but a few are selected. Many are called, but a few are selected. So we belong to the selected few. We must have that faith in ourselves. Swamiji is telling, be of cheer. We can think that you are born, believe that you are selected. You are born to do great things, and we will do. So these are wonderful words, some words of Swami Vivekananda. Manifest the divinity within you, and everything will be harmoniously arranged around it. Those who are always downhearted and dispirited in this life cannot do work. From life to life, they come and go wailing and moaning. So Swami Vivekananda is telling, man has infinite power within himself, and he can realize it. It can be done, but you do not believe it. That is the problem. Believe in my words. Stand up on your own feet and strive, and you will be successful. So you are strong, omnipotent, omniscient, no matter that you have not expressed it yet. It is in you. All knowledge is in you. All power, all purity, and all freedom. Why cannot you express this knowledge? Because you do not believe in it. Believe in it, and it must, and it will come out. So all these wonderful words of inspiration by Swami Vivekananda, that you think your Atman, this Atman is the same in all. It is not that some power will come from outside. Swami is telling, I had a little frustration in my life at one point of my life, and I was asking for help. I cried for help, and no help came from outside. And at last, when it came from within. So see the wonderful ideas of Swami Vivekananda. Encouragement, inspiration, that enthusiasm. He himself experienced all these things. His guru, Sri Ramakrishna, said long back that Naren will shake the world to its foundations. Naren will teach the world. So long back, Swami Vivekananda, the guru, Sri Ramakrishna, said, and Narendranath proved this. Wherever he was the leader of the group, because his mind was always full of positive ideas. And Swami Vivekananda is telling that weakness, it is the sin. Strength, stop becoming weak. It is that we want so much in this life. Strength. For what we call sin and sorrow have all one cause, and that is our weakness. With weakness comes ignorance, and with ignorance comes misery. Never be weak. You must be strong. You have infinite strength within you. Never think there is anything impossible for the soul. It is the greatest heresy to think so. If there is sin, this is the only sin to say that you are weak. All weakness, all bondage is imagination. Do not weaken. Stand up and be strong. That is all the religion I know. This, even after 126 years, how relevant Swamiji's quotes are, teachings are. Swamiji is telling, and I quote, "We are suffering from this virus, this COVID." Swamiji is telling 125 years, 26 years back, the weak have no place here in this life or in any other life. Weakness leads to slavery. Weakness leads to all kinds of misery, physical and mental. Weakness is death. There are hundreds of thousands of microbes surrounding us, but they cannot harm us unless we become weak. Until the body is ready and predisposed to receive them, there may be a million microbes of misery floating about us. Never mind, they dare not approach us. They have no power to get a hold on us until the mind is weakened. This is the great fact. Strength is life, weakness is death. Strength is felicity, life eternal, immortal. Weakness is constant strain and misery. Weakness is death. So, wonderful ideas of this gospel of strength, gospel of fearlessness by Swami Vivekananda. What we want is strength, so believe in yourselves. So now I will just quote a few quotations by a few words from this. Rabindranath Tagore is telling, Vivekananda's gospel marked the awakening of man in his fullness, and that is why it inspired our youth to the diverse courses of liberation through work and sacrifice. Rishi Aurobindo was a freedom fighter. So he underwent and became a follower of Swami Vivekananda. And he says, the going forth of Swami Vivekananda, marked out by the master, Sri Ramakrishna, as the heroic soul destined to take the world between his two hands and change it, was the first visible sign to the world that India was awake not only to survive, but to conquer. So how the Indian youths, Indian freedom fighters, Indian political leaders, Indian social activists were influenced, and Indian spiritual seekers also got inspiration from the life and teachings of Swami Vivekananda. So we find all this in the sayings of these people. This Bal Gangadhar Tilak, he was telling Tilak is telling, Vivekananda roused the much needed national consciousness of Bharat. He compared Vivekananda's role with that of Adi Shankaracharya. Vivekananda was compared with Shankaracharya, and Raja Gopalachari, another one, is telling he is the father of the Indian nationalism, Indian freedom movement. So these are the words by the then leaders of Indian political field area. Mahatma Gandhiji is telling, I have come here to Belurmath to pay my homage and respect to the revered memory of Swami Vivekananda, whose birthday is being celebrated today, 6th February 1921. I have gone through his works very thoroughly, and after having gone through them, the love that I had for my country became a thousandfold and inspiring the youngsters. I ask you, young men, not to go away empty-handed without imbibing something of the spirit of the place where Swami Vivekananda lived and died. This was the inspiration got by Mahatma Gandhiji. And Mahatma Gandhiji influenced Nelson Mandela and many others. So how the influence of Swami Vivekananda worked like a chain. In a chain way, it worked generation after generation. And we find that till it is working. Subhash Chandra Bose is telling, I cannot write about Vivekananda without going into raptures. Few indeed could comprehend or fathom him, even among those who had the privilege of becoming intimate with him. His personality was rich, profound, and complex, and it was this personality, as distinct from his teachings and writings, which accounts for the wonderful influence he has exerted on his countrymen, and particularly on Bengalis. This is the type of manhood which appeals to the Bengali as probably none other. Reckless in his sacrifice, unceasing in his activity, boundless in his love, profound and versatile in his wisdom, exuberant in his emotions, merciless in his attacks, but yet simple as a child, he was a rare personality in this world of ours. This wonderful ideas, this inspiration he got from Swami Vivekananda, this Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. And he was telling, had he been alive today, I would have sat at his feet. and accepted him as my guru. So Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, Vinoba Bhave is telling another social activist, Vivekananda not only made us conscious of our strength, he also pointed out our defects and drawbacks. So this, he guided us, he made us realize our power in the path of Vedanta. So Vinoba Bhave is telling, Roma Rola is telling that he, Vivekananda, was energy personified and action was his message to men. For him, as for Beethoven, it was the root of all the virtues. His preeminent characteristic was kingliness. He was a born king, and nobody ever came near him, either in India or America, without paying homage to his majesty. So these were the wonderful words of some of the luminaries. Will Durant, this Western seventh, this Will Durant is writing about Swami Vivekananda, how he also was inspired, and he is writing, this Mr. Will Durant, that he, Swami Vivekananda, preached to his countrymen a more virile creed than any Hindu had offered them since Vedic days. It is a man-making religion that we want. Give up this weakening mysticism and be strong. That was the message of Swami Vivekananda, Will Durant. See, Raja Gopalacharya, the first Governor General of India, was telling Swami Vivekananda saved Hinduism and saved India. But for him, we would have lost our religion and would not have gained our freedom. We therefore owe everything to Swami Vivekananda. May his faith, his courage, and his wisdom ever inspire us so that we may keep safe the treasure we have received from him. So there is no end of speaking about Swami Vivekananda's influence on the youngsters. So young people are very, as I say, idealistic. They like to have a hero. That is why, see, Swami Vivekananda's birthday has been chosen by the, declared by the Indian government as the National Youth Day, to inspire the youth, not only in India, everywhere. And today is a wonderful day that we have got this opportunity to celebrate this day of Swami Vivekananda's birth, who inspired the whole world and guided and led towards the goal, celestial goal, absolute goal, the supreme. And today we offer our homage to Swamiji and pray that Swamiji's inspiration may work through all of us and bring a change in the society which we are passing through at present, with many problems and miseries. There is a saying, I will conclude with that, with one quote. Sarve sukhino santu, sarve santu niramayaha, sarve bhadrani pashantu, ma kaschit dukkha bhag bhavet. May all be happy, may all be free of diseases, may all see good in everything, and may none should suffer from any misery. Om shanti, shanti, shanti. Jai to Swami Vivekananda.
Thank you so much, Revered Swamiji, for that beautiful, inspiring talk. We got to learn so much, not just only on Swamiji's teachings and his life, but also it's an inspiration to us all youth to consider and understand Swamiji's writings, knowledge, and scripture in our daily lives. Next, we will be having an Odissi dance performance by Mr. Saurav Mohanty, an artist from India.
Yeah. Maheshwara Murvala Bhaskara Ishta Mamara Maravandyam Murta Maheshwara Murvala Bhaskara Ishta Mamara Maravandyam Vande Vedatanu Mujita Garita Kanchana Kamini Murta Maheshwaram Ujvala Bhaskaram Ishtam Amara Maravandyam Koti Bhanu Karadipta Singha Maho Koti Tata Kopina
I hope you enjoyed that beautiful dance performance as much as we did to commemorate the Swami Vivekananda Jayanti celebrations. With that, we've come to the close of Swami Vivekananda Jayanti celebrations, and I'd like to invite Mr. Sipiwayam Shunu from the Swami Vivekananda Cultural Center at the Consulate General of India in Durban to render this evening's vote of thanks.
Namaskar and greetings to all of you. On behalf of Swami Vivekananda Cultural Center at the Consulate General of India in Durban, it gives me a great pleasure to deliver a vote of thanks on today's program of Swami Vivekananda Jayanti celebrations. Allow me to thank the following who took part on today's program. Revered Swami Sumanasananda, who gave remarks on Swami Vivekananda message for the youth. Secondly, allow me to thank Nivar Brijmohan, Vishar Chukriya, and Torana Birbal, who performed Bhajan item this evening. These three wonderful youth are the members of Ramakrishna Center of South Africa in Glen Annel. Thirdly, allow me to thank Mr. Saurav Mohanty, who is also a youth member of Ramakrishna Center of South Africa in Glen Annel, for rendering of Odissi performance. So to Swami Sumanasananda Ji, Nivarji, Vishalji, and Toranaji, thank you for taking part on today's program. Lastly, to Mr. Soran Mahanti for rendering of Odissi performance. To Director of the Swami Vivekananda Cultural Center in Devon, Dr. Chaitanya Prakash Yogi, Mr. Sristi Harinarayan, Mr. Piyush Kanderwal, thank you very much for taking part on today's program. To our online participant, thank you for being with us this evening. You are kindly advised to visit ICCR in Durban Facebook page for more information on cultural activities organized by Swami Vivekananda Cultural Center in Durban. To once again, to Swami Sumanasananda Ji, Nivarji, Visharji, Toranaji, Soranaji, thank you for taking part on today's program. To all of you, have a wonderful evening. Namaskar.